You may notice something different the next time you visit some local restaurants.
It's a change that could spread to even more places thanks to a local environmentalist. News Channel 5's Katie Johnson's here to explain that. Katie?
Kelly, if you go to Howley's or Longboards in West Palm Beach, don't expect a straw in your drink. One local woman says this small change will make a big difference on our beaches.
Potato chip bag, styrofoam, and a large jug.
There's a lot of trash.
Not what you'd hope to see on Palm Beach, but it's a reality here and at beaches across the state.
It's disheartening. It really does crush my heart.
Diane Bueller calls herself the beach gardener. When she's not working or diving, she's cleaning up local beaches.
And the amount of marine life that's there is so diverse and so abundant and so fragile at the end of the day when it comes to what we can impede upon it with the trash that ends up out there.
Much of that trash, she says, is plastic.
A lot of plastic. Tons of plastic. And it's coming in from everywhere.
And a lot of the plastic is
straw.
According to the Ocean Conservancy, millions of straws pollute the ocean every year.
And it's a simple task to not use a straw. It's one of those things when people ask for answers to the problems that we have, things they can do on a daily basis. That's the simplest.
A simple fix that's now in use at Howley's and Longboards.
We're going to biodegradable straws and we're not using any straws in our drinks unless the customer requests them.
The change has been in effect at Longboards for 2 weeks.
It was kind of cool because a lot of people just kind of were like, okay, well, I don't need one.
Now the restaurant's managers are trying to get other local businesses to follow the trend. According to the Ocean Conservancy, if 25,000 people skip the straw every time they visit a restaurant, it'll keep 5 million straws out of oceans and landfills.
And straws are just one of many items found on local beaches. Diane says her next goal is to keep people from leaving their cigarette butts off the beach. And if you've ever done a beach cleanup, I know I have, you know cigarettes are something you'll find a lot of in the sand. Katie Johnson, WPTV News Channel 5.
Katie, thank you.